for a walk. God and Enoch was going for a walk, and God said, well, since we're closer to my house, why don't we just go on up to my house? Because you seem like a righteous person. Since we're so close to my house, let us just go on up to my house.
Yes.
And that's the way we should be with God. As we walk with God, hallelujah, God should say, come on over to your mansion. I've already prepared for you. Come on over here. I got one on your street, hallelujah. Your street is named after you, hallelujah. And a mansion sits on your street, and you can just come on home, hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
How many want to be like Enoch, hallelujah?
Yeah.
Just walk on in, hallelujah. God said, come on in, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. The church today, hallelujah, was established on faith. Somebody say, prove it. Acts 16 and 5 said, and so were the churches established in faith and increased in numbers daily. So without faith, we cannot grow, y'all.
Right.
Praise God. Amen.
The churches were built on faith.
For sure.
And we definitely were built on faith.
For sure.
Because who would have saw the numbers that we have right now?
Come on.
And we've only come this far. We haven't made it to the completion of this journey yet. As far as we came, hallelujah.
Amen.
But can you see God working in the midst of it? I need you to increase your faith, you know. I don't want you to be like the ones he said, oh ye a little faith. I want you to be the one he said, oh much faith, hallelujah. Much faith, hallelujah. They got much faith over there in covenant. They got much faith, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
87:65. We got much faith. We believe in God. I need your belief to come up to believe what thus says the Lord. Hallelujah. If God said it to me, hallelujah, and I say it to you, hallelujah, you ought to have enough faith to believe it. Hallelujah. Because the moment you begin to doubt, you begin to cancel out things that's supposed to be manifested right there for you. Hallelujah. You know how you went and prayed for somebody, and the first thing you say is, they ain't going to make it.
You just cancel that prayer.
You just cancel out everything you just said.
Right.
People of God, our faith has to come up to the level of our actions.
Yes.
Because what you say should be matching, hallelujah.
That's right.
Don't pray for me and then turn around and say, I don't know if he's going to make it.
Jesus.
I don't even want the prayer. You can keep that. You can take that on back home with you, hallelujah. You can put that back in the box, hallelujah. Wrap it up and take it on back home with you. Because I don't want that. Because I don't want anything where you got to doubt about what you do for me, hallelujah. Even if you're giving it. If you got to doubt what you're giving, don't give it. Because God don't want your hands dealt. He don't want your peace up.
Amen.
He don't want no pieces. Hallelujah. If you can't give God your all, you sing the song, you want to be in his presence, you want to give him your all, but what do you do? This is why Christianity is despising as is such.
Yes.
Because we are saying and doing two different things.
That's right.
Our giving don't even match what God has said.
Come on.
Okay, they say pastors can't talk about it, but I can.
Amen.
Because if God tells me, I just do what he tells me to do.
That's right.
Because as one man said, if you're not giving 10%, you're just giving an offering.
That's right.
Don't write tabs on that.
That's right. Come on.
Speak about it. If you don't give your 10%, it's just all right. I didn't say that. But God said, give him what's due him, right?
That's right.
Come on, read for me before I get thrown out. Hallelujah.
Verse 6. Hallelujah. But without faith, it is impossible to please him.
You won't find impossible many places in the Bible, but you find it right here where it says impossible. Which means I'm impossible.
Amen.
God is saying, in your impossibility, I am possible.
I like that.
For all things are possible with God.
That's what he said.
So he's telling you right here, without faith, that means the things that you cannot see. See, the things you see are just temporal.
That's right.
The things you see and that you can accomplish with your own natural ability, those are not faith. Faith is the things you cannot see. Do you see yourself as an entrepreneur? You see that shop that God is trying to give you. You see that job that God is offering. Promotions come from God. But when you attach yourself to a place that believes that,
oh my,
We bring it and manifest it right here in the natural.
That's it.
So your promotion, hallelujah. Anybody been promoted since they've been at CRCL?
Jesus.
Because we believe you. Anybody got a new job since they've been at CRCL?
Yes.
Anybody been healed since they've been at CRCL?
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Anybody seen a miracle since they've been at CRCL?
Yes.
But that's what God, we have to be, hallelujah. Our actions have to match our faith, hallelujah. We got to bring our faith into what we believe what God said. I didn't say I did none of that.
That's right.
I said did God do that? Through you, hallelujah. God speaks to people. God does miracles through you, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. But it's your faith, hallelujah. Faith that even healed people.
That's right.